Hey family, how's everybody doing? Hello, 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 hello. Y'all got the fan going, I got the, trying to get all this together. I know my food got cold, but luckily it's that kind of food where, you know, tastes too bad, not real, real hot, you know. These hot flashes, you guys. I know there's some of you out here that know exactly what I'm going through. And I'm going through it tough, you guys, like real tough. I mean, they just be hitting me when I don't want them to hit me. Looking for my debit card, my purse, one hit. At the grocery store, walking through an aisle, somebody say hi to me, it hit me. They want to make a conversation. Oh, hey, how you doing? It hit me. Being a drive-thru, rumbling through my purse or looking for something, it hit me. Every time when you don't want it to hit you, it's gonna hit you, and it definitely hit me in my sleep throughout the night. She used to be soaked. One time my husband rolled over, he was like, oh my God, what happened? The bed is wet, what happened? You know, in other words, like, did you think I peed on myself or something? I said, that's the hot flashes, that's how much I be sweating. He was like, oh no, babe, we gotta change the sheets. I said, I agree. But I did get some medication from my doctor. So they have subsided quite a bit. I don't get them real bad sweats, so I'm dripping and got to change my sheets and all that. Anyway, my food's cold enough, y'all. I miss you guys so much. Thank you for all of my new subscribers. I hope y'all can see. Y'all can see me. I'm sorry. I was rushing trying to get this all set up for y'all and stuff. I don't know, I think that's worse. Okay. Anyway, this is what we're having. Check it out, y'all. Check it out, check it out, check it out. We got here some baked chicken, baked garlic. I'll just call it garlic baked chicken. We have onion rings because I'm going to post what onion rings that I used, and what, I don't have any of the curly fries, but there was just a little bit left, so my husband and son got those, but my husband wanted curly fries and onion rings, and my son wanted string beans, so I kind of did both, and I eat both, so I got to get all of it. So there's a little shoestring, you know, little old school canned string beans put together. And then I have tomatoes with avocado. Didn't have any Italian dressing, guys, so I put a little Thousand Island. So we're gonna work with what we got. Let's get a grub on. Got that sriracha. Definitely stays on premises. I go crazy if I don't have it. And you know what? Spicy foods will jump kick you a hot flash in a minute. But it's worth it. It's worth it. I don't feel like this light is right, y'all. I really don't. Okay. Alright. Let's dig on in. So, what are you guys up to? What did you guys have for dinner tonight? Hell, what you have for breakfast and lunch? I'd be interested in knowing if I didn't already see a video. If you're a mukbanger, yeah. Let's go and take a bite of this. Guys. I have been tagged by guess who? My girl, Yaki Snacky. I have been tagged by her for almost a month now, and I have yet to do the video because it's like, either I have my son, or like last weekend, you know, my sisters were here. Something would come aware, which is a little inconvenient. at the time to do the tech, or I didn't have enough time. I know one time I didn't have enough time. I was talking and I'm not having enough time. Guacamole, avocado. Get it? Got it? Good. So, string beans, get it? Got it? Good. I want to put her channel, link her channel, this specific video in my description box. I'm going to try and do that. I've never done that where I put another YouTuber or Moonfinger's channel in the description box yet. I barely write anything in my description box, but I do everything else, my tags and all that other stuff you got to do when you upload the video. So by the time I get to that, I'll just pretty much write whatever I'm going to, whatever I'm, you know, talking to you guys about in the comments or something. Anywho, I've been tagged too. She made a video. Like I said, I'm going to try and do that. If I can't figure it out, I'll keep trying. Then when I do figure it out, I'll mention it in my video. But she's Yakky Snacky. Y-A-C-K-Y. It's all one word, Snacky. S-N-A-C-K-Y. Yakky Snacky. All one. Check her out. She's awesome. She's one of a kind. I love her videos. She has an I don't give a attitude. I've shouted her out before in my video. So, and I'm sure a lot of you already know her. She's been around. Anywho. She asked in her video. And you got after. She tagged me. I was like, oh my God, why did you even say something in the comments or say anything about the tag, right? But it's all good. That's just like my first impression when she was like, you've been tagged. Until I'm like, oh no, not me, you know. She wanted to know, and she also expressed and expressed why this person was her most the most odd person that she knows. So I put in the description box, she wanted to know for you to comment, who was the most odd person in your life or that you knew,
right?
So I was commenting on my girl, so and I watch her entire videos, and like I said, most people that I'm subscribed to, pretty much I'm watching your entire video unless literally I had to stop and do something else. Most of my favorite, most of you, I'm watching your entire video, trust me, and I'm not just saying that. So, okay, stuff like this happened. Or you might ask something in the middle or in the video, and that's how you know when people are really watching the video. Anyhow, I understand some people just, attention span just ain't all that, you know, or, and not just, I'm talking about as far as mukbangs or stuff like that, like your attention span can be great, you know, academically, but I'm just talking about the videos in particular. Anyway. I feel like I was wanting to say something else about that. So, I wrote in the comments my most, odd person in my life or favorite odd person in my life is my husband. Because to me, he's not like anyone else. He's it's in a good way though. He is very different, very different, very intelligent, very responsible. You could talk to him about anything, you could ask him anything, politics, sport, anything. He gonna give you the answer. He gonna know the answer. I promise. Most likely he gonna know. Me or most people, some particular different subjects you may not be as, or topics you may not be ahead of the game on, and more than others. You might know a lot about sports, but you might not know a lot about cooking, or you might not know a lot about cars or stuff like that. But with my husband, as far as I, he pretty much gonna know. And if he doesn't, he's gonna find out. So he will not be put in that predicament ever again of not knowing. So anyway, my husband and Yaki Snacky, as you know, is my favorite most odd person. And that's one of the reasons why. Almost time off. Anyways. Get it? Got it? Good. It's because, okay, like when we first met, ooh, that's a heck of a crunch on that. My husband does not smoke. My husband does not drink. My husband does not hardly even like go out, even with his friends. They talk, but most of his friends are married anyway. But still, you know, some people, just because you're married, don't mean you can't get out, right? Or hang with your friend, even participate in job functions or whatever, Christmas dinners, Christmas holiday, whatever. No, he stays home. That's all he want to do. To me, that's a little odd. You gonna want to do something. I mean, even on our anniversary, I'm like, just take a sip of wine or champagne. Nope. And all the 21 years, that man would not touch a drink, a sip. He don't even want to smell the alcohol. So, yeah, that's a little odd because, as you know, most of us, if we don't drink or fine, we don't smoke cigarettes. Because like I've told you guys, it's been 6 years I've quit smoking. And I'm so glad I decided to do that, especially at this stage in my life that I have not shared with you guys yet, that I will be sharing with you. So, again, I have my reasons why I have to wait to do that publicly. But anyway, my husband is a... he's just that way. So, at first, I thought... oh no, he's boring. He's a straight, what you call L7. So if you have an L, wait a minute, L, oh, you guys just made an L, and then you have a 7, number 7, right? Can you guys see that? This is L, this thing is messed up. 7, you have L, then you have a 7. Somehow it's supposed 7 and oh, L and a 7. L7. There we go. Anyway, it's supposed to be square. My fingers just messed up. I ain't gonna lie. And this L7 was just a square to me. At first, I didn't appreciate it. I was, you know, when we were married, I was still young, you know. In my 20s, I can't really appreciate something like that at that time. But because I knew he was an awesome person, I wasn't gonna let that man go. Also, when nobody say about him, or he don't come to family functions, he never wanna do nothing, I don't care. He is awesome, he is the best man I have ever met. Although in my entire life, personally, and I am proud to claim him as my husband. So, Yaki Snacky, there's probably a couple more things, but I'm running out of time. I want to try and eat, but that's why my husband is my most favorite, or is the most favorite odd person in my life. and I love him dearly. I thank God for him every day, and no one can ever change that. And that's just, it is what it is. I feel straight from heaven, a blessing straight from God, just hand in hand. He just handed it to me. From God's hands to my hand, he gave me my husband. I must say, I'm truly blessed. And for me to be so blessed to have a husband like him, what you guys think I feel? I feel super special. Because I'm the one that was given that blessing from God. God chose me to give him to. You feel me? So, that's what it is, Snacky Snacky. Thanks for the tag, girl. And I'm so, so sorry that I took so long to get to it. But I really wanted to take some time and really pretty much elaborate. I didn't want it to be too short on why, you know, my husband is the most odd person in my life, because he's still the most wonderful person at the same time. So I wanted that to also be expressed when speaking about it. So anyway, let's finish eating, you guys. Jackie Snacky, thanks for the tag, girl. I gotta watch what I say though, your comments. You probably try to tag me again just because I took so long for this one, but I really hope you see this video. I love you guys. Shout out again, Jackie Snacky. Go check her channel out. It's already 17 minutes into this video. But I swear when I'm watching the video, when I'm editing it, it seems like it takes forever. Do you guys feel like that when you edit the videos? Let me know in the comments. I don't know if that's just me or what. So good, guys. So good. See, that piece of chicken is going to just annoy me until I get it up. Oh. I have time to talk about this. Right here, guys, I have some iced tea. So refreshing. I'm gonna tap on it just a little bit. And maybe I'll go further into details on another video, maybe. Or I might just decide not to even allow myself to even trip on it that hard to even discuss it any further. But I just want y'all to pin. Now, last night, right? Yeah, that was last night with Snoopy's. Yeah. And my girl YJ says, message me, sweet tea, you're up to 200 subbies. So I'm like, okay, whatever that conversation was. That's between her and I. But, so I go in there and there's, I think it was, I got up to like 202, all the way up to like the last time I looked at it, which was midnight. Last night, I wake up maybe around 10 o'clock this morning because I didn't go to bed till like 5 o'clock in the morning. Y'all know how I do. I'm up all night. So, a lot just happened. Look, because what was going on in the chat line, and not only Snoop Lee's chat line, because I think it's an awesome thing to do, but there is, to me, in my opinion, a downfall in some cases, and maybe just only in my case. I don't know. That's why I'm wearing suits. How you guys feel about it, but I had gained, I think I was at 198, and then when I got on Snoopy's channel, I think it went up to 202. Yeah, I had gained 4 subscribers, but like I said this morning, I was back at, I think at 199, so 3 of them, I'm assuming, it was the 3 that subscribed, because it always happens like that. You'll subscribe to their channel, and then they'll automatically, that night or the next day or the next day or two, they'll unsubscribe to your channel after you already subscribed there. Every time I do that sub for sub, that happens. Every freaking time. It never fails. And I don't want to say that the sub for something is bad, because like I said, maybe that only happens to me. I don't know. I don't know if it could be YouTube. But the reason why I don't think it's YouTube is because it only happens when I do the sub for sub thing on live chats. So now, I think I'm back up to 201. So, those are, I believe, like real subscribers that came across my video, like my content, and subscribe. And that's the way I like it, because you tend to keep those subscribers. In my opinion, the sub for sub things that you do in the live chats, out of 5, maybe 1, and this is me, maybe only 1 I'll keep the next day, or even a few hours later, I'm back to where I was. Or just 1 more hit, because I kept that 1. So, let me know if you guys experienced that, because I just think that's kind of messed up. I bought stuff to your channel because I like your content, and I just came across, I subbed. I'm not going to unsub, even if I'm not watching your channel as much. I'm not going to just unsubscribe. For what? The main thing of subscribing was to subscribe for a reason, not to unsubscribe, was to keep you with your subscribers. From that point on to infinity, whatever. But these people are out here, guys, doing the sub for sub jump. And then as soon as you sub to their channel, they'll unsubscribe to your channel in a minute. So, I don't know if you, like I said, you guys let me know if you're going through that, but I just think it's really effed up. I'm just being honest. And I know my grandson watches his channel, so I'm going to keep it on the low low. But I think it's, you know, messed up. I do. So, I'm going to just let y'all know now. I'm just going to be honest, because I fear no man, my channel is going to be successful. Either way, I'm not afraid to tell you guys what I'm about to tell you. But when I'm on live chats, and you say, Sweet to Delights, I sub to your channel, my response is going to be simply, thank you, I will check your channel out. I am not going to automatically subscribe to your channel and say, oh, I subscribe to your channel too. I am not doing that anymore. I will give your channel the time of the day by me checking out your channel, because, yeah, you did, you know, subscribe to my channel. I don't know if you're going to stick with me. Most of the time, you don't. But, you know, I'm not going to subscribe right away. I'm going to really look at your content. If I like it, then I'm subscribing. I'm just not going to just subscribe automatically anymore. I'm not doing the sub for sub thing anymore. If you're on Snoopy East or whoever's channel and they're like, oh, Snoopy, oh, subscribe to such and such. She, you know, she cool. I trust that because I trust Snoopy. I trust Melvin and Keisha. I trust Late Sweet Lady T Sensations. I trust Bittersweet Rose, Madison. Everybody that I watch, I trust your opinion when you say this book. But I will be checking your channel out on my own before subscribing. And I will be thanking you for subscribing to my channel and being very grateful. But we'll see how long you subscribe to my channel. I mean, you could still unsubscribe after I subscribe yours a week later, but still, you know, 9 times out of 10, that won't happen. If it does, it does. So I don't want anybody to think when everybody's subbing for subbing and I'm the only one not doing that, that is something personal. It's just that to me, I just feel like it's a waste of time to do that. And then I sub to your channel, and then an hour later or a day later, those very 3 or 5, however many subbies I sub for sub with, I'm back down to where I was. What's the use? So, I just have to get that off my chest, you guys. And you guys that are doing that, like I said, that's messed up, and you really need to reevaluate your train of thought when it comes to subscribing to people's channels just to get them to subscribe to yours, and if you unsubscribe, that shows a lot about your character. So you think nobody knows and nobody sees, but the person up there, but he sees it, and then people wonder why they're miserable, why their life is all, because you're not good, you're not a good person. So, good things can't happen to you, and if they do happen to you, if some good thing happen to run across your way, it don't last for long, because you're not a good person, so you don't know how to accept it and appreciate it the way you're supposed to be appreciated. So, anyway, I'm in this, I talked more than I ate, but I'm finished this off camera. I thank you guys for joining me, and thank you for my new subscribers that are still here. With your girl Sweet Tea, I thank all of you guys, my new and my old and my upcoming, that's watching, that's even considering subscribing. I thank you from the bottom of my heart. You guys take it easy. I will see you on the next video. Be blessed. Love you guys. Bye.